How many of you are from HUL over here? Procter & Gamble, Reckitt Benckiser, Coke, Pepsi? I'm glad. Okay, fine. No. My confidence level has gone up. Otherwise, my wife was telling me after seeing my presentation, you better wear a shield and then go and face them. I'm going to talk on a latest topic. In fact, the copy that is there in front of me is the 20th chapter of the 15th edition of our book, which Kotler and I have written. Okay, and that was basically contemporary issues. And when Vinny called me, it's actually on sustainable marketing, not contemporary issues, sustainable marketing. And when Vinny called me, I was actually thinking on working on something else. I just finished that chapter. He says we want contemporary issues in marketing. And it's made me think. It's a part of the paper that I'm writing. Maybe another couple of months' time, I should be able to send that paper to some international journal. Then it's up to them to accept it or not. But, and the topic is exactly something which would can be the 21st chapter in that book, maybe the next edition. Okay. And this is what I'm going to present. The views that I'm going to express are purely my own. My institute need not support me for that. Though I'm the director of IIM, I'm also a professor over there. My first appointment is as professor, then as director. I'm speaking as a professor of marketing or a student of this subject. And my appeal to you is, don't listen to what I say from your head. Listen to it from your heart. Let's look at it. And then let's debate among ourselves. I'll be happy if it triggers some feelings in you, especially some sort of anger. Okay? Need not go up to hatred. Let's be professional. Okay? But anger would be fine. Okay? Let's check our paradigms. I remember when I started teaching way back in 1996 at NMIMS, someone from NMIMS is there, I had a teacher of mine, okay, whom I'd ask, what is a good class? And he had said, he thought for a while and he said, when you change one paradigm in the minds of your students. And I shivered when I understood what he meant by that. And he says, don't go by the applause that you get at the end of the class, that's for oratory. Then I asked him, what is a great class? If good class is one paradigm, then what is a great class? Then he said, simply, coolly, without changing any expressions on his face, when you change more than one paradigm in their mind. I didn't dare to ask him third question. Okay? So let's look at it. Let's look at it principally, philosophically. I don't teach this subject in my class. Though I teach basic marketing in the first term also. Because it's not meant for PGP students. Maybe to PGPX, yes, I will teach. I got a PGPX student of mine also from the first batch. Okay? Yes, because when they join the organization, they join a different level. I'm saying this subject is more meaningful to you because you are all with 7-8 years of work corporate experience and you are at that stage where you can think and do something about it. A fresh PGP, when he joins as management trainee, he has to simply implement what his bosses say. His first aim is to get confirmation. Okay? So naturally, I can't expect him to think over it and apply on it. But that is what I would expect from you. But please remember, these are my views. Okay? My organization need not stand with me. I'm only securing the placements from my students. This is what typically we say. You'll find this in the very first chapter as well as on the 20th chapter of this book. This is what basically the thinking in marketing is. Okay? On the basis of needs of consumers, the moment you say marketing, consumers have to be there. And on the other side, the needs of business. Okay? See, we kept on saying of marketing concept. Then we said, no, marketing is not just sufficient thing because you just identify the needs and offer the solution. No, that's not just marketing. That was maybe 20 years ago. Then we started discussing about societal marketing. Understand the long-term society's needs and balance them with your company objectives, we said. Then, of course, strategic planning. Okay. We started with positioning, all strategic planning and other concepts started. Plan strategically where you want to position the product brand. Okay. Who are your competitors, blah, 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 blah. Strategic market planning. Today we say it's not just all this, but it is sustainable marketing. We are not just looking for this generation, but we have to leave something for the next generation. Agreed. Sustainable marketing I will equate with survival of the planet, all companies, okay, whichever it may be, wherever it may be. Yesterday I had a meeting with ITC in their Gurgaon office, ITC Hotels, and then they were proudly showing me water harvesting that they have done. Pits. If you go to HUL's office here in Andheri, they show you water harvesting and other thing that they have done, environment. New concept has emerged as green marketing. Fine, fair enough. Okay. What I'm going to refer to is future. Thing has already started. It has started, it's in nascency. But it's going to take greater heights in future. I call it as responsible marketing. We all marketeers should take responsibility, okay, for our actions as well as be accountable for them. Then every word that we speak, we should have the accountability for it. Okay. And how do I define it? I define this concept as profitable customer relationships are built on foundation of value and trust. It's triggered me, this topic actually triggered me some time back when this Nestle controversy emerged. I'm not getting into whether Nestle was right, state was right, no. That is why actually I came to this concept of foundations of value and trust. You have to tell me 2 minutes or 5 minutes before I have to close, stop. Okay? Typically, being a teacher in IIM, each session is for 1.5 hours. So, okay. So you have to tell me, okay? Yeah. Let's look at a few of these products. And now let me ask those who are married and those who have small kids, would you mind your kids feasting on this product every day? Will you give this to them in the tiffin box every day? How many of you would say yes? None? How many of you say no? Please raise your hands. Thank you. I have not branded this. It can be anything. Power drinks. I have given the references also. Every statement that I am making, every data that I am showing you is from a well-accepted published journal. The views are not my own. I'm reproducing them, okay? And I'm only making the analysis out of it. I'm not going to make any analysis also. I'm going to leave it to you. Power drinks. It's there in my book. This picture is also there in my book. I've taken it from the book. Source I've given you. Okay? Actually, the fact says, as per that article, power drinks can make you powerless. And when I go to the gym, I see many youngsters drinking that. Okay? That energizes them, they say. How did they get that idea? I asked them. They said, that's what they say. They means who? You and me, marketeers. And that's what I say, responsible. We should take responsibility for every word that we utter, whether there is legislation or not. Because people trust us. How fair are the fairness creams and their ads? Can we see that ad? I'll actually show an ad, nothing against Fair and Lovely or any company which owns that brand. Okay. How fair are these fairness creams? Let me ask all these beautiful ladies or girls sitting in front of me, would you like to be considered because you are fair or because of the intrinsic values that you have? All of you are fair, so can you tell me? A person like me develops complex because I'm not a fair-skinned person. Is it right? Can it be called as social discrimination? Can it be a part of racism? It's supposed to be how many crores of brand you said now? It's a market worth 3,000 crore as on February 2014. 3,000 crores market based on color and texture of your skin, which actually you get from your parents due to the pigments, skin pigments that you have. It has been proved medically. Yeah, show it. Let's see that, and then we can go ahead.
एक और कॉफी देना।
दूध नहीं है।
कॉफी? बेटी की कमाई यूं ही पीते जा रहे हो।
काश हमें एक बेटा होता।
कॉफी? उनको देना।
मऊआ
एयर होस्टेस
बदल दे दुनिया आपकी नए फेयर एंड लवली का फोर स्टेप एक्शन। पहला सनस्क्रीन धूप से बचाए, दूसरा चिपचिपाहट घटाए, तीसरा चेहरे से दाग हटाए और चौथा भीतर से निखारे आपको।
बेटा एक कॉफी मिलेगा?
चेहरे पे लिखे नई तकदीर, नया फेयर एंड लवली।
I showed this ad purposely because this was an ad that was bone of contention in 2003 when All India Democratic Women's Association protested against it, along with some other ads. Other ad was the picture that you are seeing on the screen, Shadi. Okay? And they considered this ad to be deemed offensive and objectionable. Company also took a note of it, changed the campaign. And they came out on the eve of Women's Day felicitating some women. Of course, the official statement read that it was just a coincidence that both the things happened. We had already planned to do it on the Women's Day. But I don't know what was, whether it was coincidence or not. I can't comment on that. I don't have any data. But what I have said just now, both pieces are exactly actual data available in public domain in printed published medium or media for that matter. The question that comes is, two things I object to this as a neutral observer and a believer in responsible marketing. Beta, are you saying that a male child is better than a female child? And if I develop that feeling, who is responsible for that? Are you ready to be accountable for the words that you have used in your commercial? Then I'll come to the second issue about fairness. How fair is fairness? Is it justifiable? Are we not creating a social stigma in the minds of those who are not fair? I know it's a big market. That's why I told you it's 3,000 plus crore market. Today, February 2014, it was 3,000 crore market. Naturally, as a marketeer, I would like to jump to it. I'd like to grab it. It's an opportunity for me. But that was what the marketing concept of the past was. Today, things have moved. Things have moved basically because consumerism is on the rise. 20 years ago, no one would have challenged. There would be so much of awareness. Okay? There won't be so many of legislations controlling you. When I speak about legislation, I also came across some article when I was working on this paper. Mexico has restricted soft drink advertisement, TV ads, especially on TV, okay, to fight obesity. They have given fixed timings in which soft drink advertisements would be aired on TV. And the ban goes from 7:30 to 7:30. 7:30 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. on weekend, Saturday, Sunday, and from 2:30 p.m. till 7:30 p.m. on every day. They don't want the kids to watch those ads, because that's the only way we can fight obesity, they said, and we can reduce it. One can, that's what this ad said, the earlier one which I showed you. No. Okay. One can. Is 10 spoons of sugar. And this is from Department of Health, West Australia. Okay. Am I providing overindulgence? I remember long back, 1994, I was working in the industry, Indo-German Chamber of Commerce, along with a German civil servant. And he was to go back. And that time he said, my worry is now, he had six kids, tax planning. In Germany, six kids, now they will start drinking soft drinks. Okay. Here at least they were drinking water. And now, I don't know how I should prevent them because no one drinks water there in Germany. They keep drinking a lot of Coke, Pepsi and other beverages. And that's going to spoil their health. are we going to take responsibility for our action? Are we at least going to promote them more ethically? And that's what I say. How fair are the fairness creams and their ads? Nothing wrong. I'm not against them promoting the fairness cream. I'm against how you promote them. Is the product chemically tested? I also come across a report which says that this fairness creams, if regularly used, do not change significantly the texture of your skin, but does affect your kidneys in the long run. I have cited that report in my paper. Are we making the consumers aware of it? Is it not our responsibility? If you are launching, if you want money, yes, we should also do that. How many of you eat apples? All of you? When you go to the grocery shop, I know those who don't use apple must have a beautiful doctor. That's what they say, no? An apple a day keeps the doctor away. The second line is, if the doctor is beautiful or handsome, throw the apple away. Okay? So that's why you guys must not be eating apples. But I eat, because my doctor is an old man, 75 years old. Okay? So when you go to buy apples, you'll find different types of apples, varieties of apples. One particular variety, Washington apples, are the brightest and the shiniest in the lot. You know why they shine so brightly? Absolutely. All of us are aware of it. And when I asked my brothers in the US, they said, yeah, we peel the skin and eat it. Skin has the maximum number of vitamins and nutrients than the contents. But why are we peeling it? Because it has wax, as you all rightly mentioned. And if you just eat it, that wax goes into it. And why waxing? Because that waxing protects and avoids dehydration, as well as improves the shelf life. You see from your point of view, what about the consumers? What about their health? If I keep on eating those vaccines, I'll be exposing myself to n number of other diseases. So few issues that we need to keep up. There are excessive markups. What is the cost of a soft drink? Say Coke or Pepsi. And how much are we charging to the consumers? Where does the money go? Deceptive prices. Deception we find in pricing strategy, we find in promotions. We don't disclose so many things in promotion. Why should there be fine bits? And that fine print is so fine that even with a magnifying glass, you can't get it. You need a microscope for that. And no one has time to read that. Packaging. Faulty packaging. We saw that in Cadbury's issue a few years ago. Worms. How did it come? Packaging was not as per the mark. High pressure, unethical selling. Yesterday, when I landed in Mumbai, I went to my home. I got a call at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, allegedly from LIC. You have bought Jeevan Anand policy? I said, I don't think so. I checked with my wife if she had bought. No. No, as per record, you have bought Jeevan Anand policy and we have not received any premium. It will lapse, premium for this year. So I would like to come and meet you. Okay. We have not bought policy, so how are we supposed to make the payment? He said, no, I'll come and explain it to you. Can you give me a home address? I said, where are you calling from? He gave me Santa Cruz address. I'm calling from, are you LIC agent? He said, no, I'm employee. Santa Cruz office. I know they have a big office in Santa Cruz, near that old airport. I said, give me your number and phone number and name. I'll call you back. Phone got disconnected. Then I contacted my agent, through whom we normally make this investment. He's a very professional guy. He says, there is no one by this name working in that office. I know them everywhere. Okay, and LIC doesn't make any calls like this. Must be some agent trying to get an appointment so that he could sell that. If you not have, why not you have it? A simple example of how unethical practice can be pursued in selling. Shoddy, harmful or unsafe products. Number of products will come under this category, especially if you see in India and developing countries. Okay. They are either not made well or do not perform well. safety of the product is in question. They'll give you a little benefit or maybe one harmful for consumption. This one example. This actual case that I'm giving you from the book, which Kotler has quoted because it's his example. Coca-Cola's vitamin water brand faced allegations for deceptive and unsubstantiated, even outlandish claims for its products. They had to withdraw that. The thing was mentioned on the label. And therefore, it was upheld, appeal was upheld, and they had to withdraw. Harmful products. I mentioned this to you some time back. We encourage our kids to drink soft drinks. We ourselves drink so much of soft drinks. Are they necessary? Are they needed? How much amount of sugar do we eat? Unwanted sugar. And what good do they do to your health? Deceptive advertising. I'll just close after this. Deceptive advertising. Most of the advertisements that we find in India are deceptive. Most of the brands that they call themselves, that themselves are best, are nothing but creating deceptive advertisements. There are many countries, especially Germany, which has banned the word like best, largest. You can't say that. On what basis can you say best? Every automobile is best in India. Every business school is based in India. There are schools ranked number one in different ways. Okay. And they advertise on TV. Do I become taller by drinking a food drink? Just because I know the time is only 20 minutes, I'm not going into details. Okay. I tried a lot, right from my childhood, because I'm a short guy, my height did not increase beyond. I got it from my parents. Do they become, I told you that, taller, stronger, sharper? I started giving my son also the same drink, Bonvita. I thought he will also compete with the aeroplane. Nothing happened. Do I become fairer by using a cream? I mentioned that. Are these fairness creams clinically tested for their long-term impact on human body? I did mention to you that earlier. In sum, I would like to conclude what exactly I wanted to say and what the paper is all about. Marketers should understand their responsibility and be accountable for their actions. And that's what I say is responsible marketing all about. And the purpose of choosing this topic for today is many of you are in that position in your companies. Follow whatever principles that you are following responsibly. Understand your responsibility to the stakeholders, not only just to the profits and bottom line to your management, also to the customer, also to the society at large. See the impact of your advertisement that will create on small kids. These small kids accept every word that they see at its face value. You are responsible for their well-being, okay? And be accountable for your actions. Thank you.